Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Rama Rama Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare Rama Rama Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare
Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama,
Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
संकीर्तन की शील प्रभुपाद की गौर भक्त वृंद की विल सिंग वन शॉर्ट सॉन्ग and move this one. यशुमति नंदन प्रवर नागर
यशुमति नंदन ब्रजवर नागर
गोकुल रंजन काना परण धन मदन मनोहर
गोपी परण धन मदन मनोहर
कलियाद मन वेधाना कुलनाशन
भज जन पालना सुरकुलनाशन
नंद गोधन रखवाला
नंद गोधन रखवाला
तर गोपी वसन हर
यमुना तट शर गोपी वसन हर
रास राशि कख पाया
रासिका कृपा मोया
राधा वल्लभ वृंदावन रतवर
राधा वल्लभ वृंदावन नटवर
भक्ति विनोदाश्रय
भक्ति विनोदाश्रय
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Krishna, Krishna.
हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे
संकीर्तन की कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की श्री श्री राधा कुंज बिहारी की श्री श्री गौनताय की श्रील प्रभुपाद की। तिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुःवन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमावों विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृन्द। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्ण। वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द लास्ट सेशन ऑफ बिहेवियरल साइंस फॉर यूथ टुडे। आई हैड डन दिस वर्दी मास्टर ऑन सैटरडे द पार्ट वन आई हैड डन टुडे आई एम डूइंग पार्ट टू टुडे। सो आई एम जस्ट शोइंग यू द स्लाइड्स आई विल नॉट स्पीक ऑन दिस द वन व्हिच आई डिड इन द प्रीवियस क्लास। कृष्णा इज द बेस्ट लीडर greatest teacher, best disciple and servant of Guru, best joy-giving son, most brilliant student, best friend, best master of Pandavas, best reciprocator, best king of Dwaraka, best worshipper of his devotees, best protector, best husband of the queens of Dwaraka, and best schoolmate of Gurukulmate of Sudama Brahman. And Krishna is always joyful and giving joy to his devotees. He is known for his saushilyata, simplicity in dealing with cows and birds and monkeys in Vrindavan. He is a master of communication in a crisis situation, the battlefield of Kurukshetra. And how he is an ocean of knowledge. Vavadukha, I explained all these things. He is a fully blossomed Purna Purushottam personality who taught Narada how to play Veena. And his flute thrills everybody in the whole universe. And he is called as Purna Purushottam. Why? Because he acted as a covered boy, a legendary guru, an obedient and brilliant student, a great king, a protector, ideal friend, philosopher, accomplished charioteer, master flute player in so many ways. His life is a complete life of ultimate God, Purna Purushottam Krishna. Now we will proceed further. This is a very beautiful verse from Uddhava Gita. Uddhava is glorifying Krishna with this verse, how Krishna is the worthy master for surrender. Each word is very beautifully explained with pastimes. So after hearing this, you will appreciate why one should take shelter of Krishna.
Tasmad bhavantam anavadyam anantaparam. Sarvajnam ishwara makuntha vikuntha dishnyam. Nirvinnadhe rahamuhe vrijanabhitapto. Narayanam narasakham sharanam prapadye.
Translation.
Therefore, O Lord, feeling weary of material life and tormented by its distresses, I now surrender unto you, because you are the perfect master. You are the unlimited, all-knowing Supreme Personality of Godhead, whose spiritual abode in Vaikuntha is free from all disturbances. In fact, you are known as Narayan, the true friend of all living beings.
Yeah. Narayana means the repository of all the jivas. At the time of Pralaya, all jivas stay in the navel of Narayana. So it's called Narayana. Narayana. So he's saying many words in this. Each word is analyzed in the subsequent slides. First he's saying, Tasmad Bhavantam Anavadyam. He's saying. Anavadyam means one who is spotlessly pure. That's the meaning of Anavadyam. Read it.
Therefore, Krishna is described as Anavadyam. There are no discrepancies in the personal conduct or character of the personality of Godhead. He is eternally faultless.
Like you see the sun here. The sun absorbs the urine but never gets contaminated. Similarly, Krishna takes away the sinful reactions of even the most sinful. Like you see, he is killing Putana, who came to imitate the behavior of a mother and kill Krishna. But he awarded her the position of a nurse in the spiritual world. So he is so spotlessly pure that he made her whole body rendering it fragrant. When the Vajabhasis, after Putana's death, they cut her body into pieces to burn it. It was burning like agarbati. Aguru smell was coming from her body because of Krishna's lip touch. So you can see how pure Krishna is. Just by touching her body with two lips, as a small baby drinking milk from Putana, who came to do a drama as a mother, he made her completely fragrant. And also he's spotless in his behavior. Like you see here, he's about to leave for Dwaraka. Yudhishthira Maharaj is coming, walking behind the chariot. Krishna is repeatedly persuading him, please go back, you are my elder. It's not proper for me to go on the chariot when you are following me. But Yudhishthira is coming and requesting, can you please stay a little longer? And Krishna is unable to refuse. Immediately he stopped his chariot and then got down and went with Yudhishthira and stayed for a few days. Then he was about to leave. Then his sister Subhadra was morose. He looked at her and understood that Abhimanyu has passed away. So she is very morose. So he went and told her that I am especially staying back for some more days just to spend time with you. So for the sister's sake, he stayed some more days. For Yudhishthira's sake, he stayed some more days. You can see that. In this way, although he is Supreme Lord, he is very malleable and bendable by his devotees. Here you see him washing the feet of Sudama Brahmana in the Dwaraka. Although he is king of Dwaraka, he becomes a servant of his devotees. He doesn't maintain the kingship in front of his devotees. So in this way, he is spotlessly pure in his behavior, character, in his purity. Here you see, in this world, people appear very attractive, as you see here. Read it.
We may be attracted by the good qualities of a particular man or demigod.
Like this girl is looking for a suitable husband. As soon as she saw him coming in a horseback, looks like a very chivalrous warrior. So she thought, oh, such a hero, great hero is coming. I think he is coming to marry me. She is thinking like that.
But we may later discover discrepancies in that person's behavior.
Yeah. He is an old fellow, baldy fellow. And she is like, her jaws dropped, seeing the old man with the big tummy and with a bald head. So in this way, in this world, many people can show off for some time. But very soon the discrepancies show up. You all heard about the Tiger Woods, I think, right now? Tiger Woods, yeah. So people had very high opinion about him, and he was so popular across the globe, isn't it? But then when this character was revealed, you know, nobody could appreciate it anymore. You will see that in this world, people put trust in people, and then after some time, they show their colors. Some people are like a chameleon, we call it. You know, chameleon means in grass it is green, in a tree it is brown. It changes colors. Similarly, people also, they appear to be people of character, but at certain time they have no character. Like Indra, for example, every year he was giving rains to Vrijavasis. And they were also very grateful. They were also giving him Indra Puja. But one particular year, Krishna told Vrijavasis not to worship Indra. He has become very proud. He told them to worship Govardhan. What did Indra do? You can see he changed his colors. Not only he did not give rains to Vrijavasis, he bit them with rain. He wanted to kill the cows and calves and all the Vrijavasis. So even a demigod sometimes can behave like that. He can go mad, like Indra went, you can see that. So in this world, anavadyam, spotlessly pure people are difficult to see. In fact, Lakshmi Devi came with a garland from the milk ocean during the churning of the milk. And she looked all around for a suitable husband. Who can be my husband? She said, people like Durvasa, oh, they sleep in the bank of a river, sometimes in a gufa, completely austere, they can walk on water, fly on sky, very powerful siddhis they have. But he becomes angry unnecessarily. Durvas means difficult to live with, such a person. She said, therefore, that is a blemish. Then she said, what about Ravana? Oh, Ravana has brought a beautiful woman from all parts of the world, and he gives them gold, silver, nice palace, nice foods, everything. But he's a characterless fellow. He is stealing other men's wives. Like Ravana took away Sita from Ram. Also, he's perishable. He was finished by Ram. So they don't have a very long duration of life. Useless. Then she said, what about Indra? Oh, Indra is the chief of all the demigods. All the demigods salute him. He is a leader of gods, demigods. And he has a very handsome body also. He holds a very big position amongst the demigods. But he is a darpok, he is a fearful fellow. You know, when asuras, Indra is sometimes sitting in the Nandanandana garden and relishing very nice music sung by some apsara. Another apsara is dancing and another apsara is playing veena. He is in a very peaceful condition. Sometimes asuras attack heaven, like Bali Maharaj and others, and they attack. Bah! They come, Indra to catch his dhoti and run for his life. He is a coward. What is the use of having a cowardly person as a husband? Useless, she said. And she said, what about Shiva? Oh, Shiva is called as a very auspicious one. Known for his sublime, very good qualities of so many qualities. But he lives in a shmashan. He lives in a graveyard. He puts basma all over his body. You know, although his wife is Durga, who can provide all best of facilities, he doesn't live in a very palatial building. He lives in a shmashan and he wears, you know, deer skin and things like that. And he has jata all over his body. So she said he lives in unclean places like graveyard. So like that, she was rejecting one person, talking about each of them. And she said, oh, Shukracharya, I heard that he is the most learned, most intelligent. But, you know, he uses his intelligence for cheating others. Like he told Bali Maharaj to speak lies that he told, I'll give 3 steps of land to Amanadev. Then he told him, you speak lie now that you will not give. You tell Vamanadev that I forgot that I promised you or whatever. So in this way, Shukracharya's knowledge is useless. It's rendered useless because he taught Bali to speak lies, and of course Bali didn't oblige. But the point remains, due to mental attachment for his remuneration, he thought if Bali becomes bondi, everything he loses, then what about my monthly salary pack? How will I get it? He was thinking like that. That means materially attached, she said. So in this way, she considered various personalities. At last, she said, there is only one person who is spotlessly pure, Lord Narayana. And he has not even an iota of defect. So then Lakshmi decided to garland Narayana and accept him as her husband. She said that actually he has no fault. Still he has one fault, she said. What is the fault? He is not after me. He is completely self-satisfied. Same with Krishna also. Krishna was completely self-satisfied. But the 16,000 princesses in the Bhaumasura's palace begged him, please kindly accept us. So he said, okay, if you all are my devotees, you want me to marry you, I will accept you. He accepted. Some people foolishly think that Krishna was after so many beautiful women. Actually, you will read in the Srimad Bhagavatam. There is a verse, very beautiful verse, which says, Uddhama bhava pishunama laval guhasa vridavaloka nihato madanopiyasam sammuhya chapama jahat pramadottamasta yasyendriyam vimatithum kuhakairna shekuhu. So if you go to Bhagavatam 10th canto, and in Bhagavatam you put yasyendriyam, vimatithum, or kuhakair, you put, you will get this shloka, a very beautiful verse. In this verse he says, yasya indriyam vimatitum kuhakair nasheku, means the beautiful queens of Dwaraka with their sparkling eyes, with their jet black long hair, with their smiling faces with bashful feminine smiles, and they were all wearing costly saris and jewelry in their body, and they had the perfection of feminine beauty with their attractive bodies, they could not agitate the mind of Krishna. Rather, Krishna was only attracted to only one thing in them, their seva bhava. When Krishna would come back in the evening, they would wash his feet, do arati for him, feed him prasad, fan him. Seeing their service attitude, seva bhava, that touched his heart. For that matter, even a calf, cow or calf would give milk, Krishna was attracted to that service attitude. Prabhupada says for Krishna, there was no difference between Radharani and a cow when it comes to service attitude. Whoever has service attitude, Prabhupada says, Krishna would immediately accept it. So, if he was attracted to beautiful girls, but why was he attracted to Kubja, who was ugly and having a hunchback? Because she had a service attitude to take Chandan and apply on Krishna Balaram's forehead. And he rendered her body very beautiful. By a blessing. So you can see Narayana or Krishna, they can't be fascinated by any beauty, and they have no discrepancy. Anavadyam. Spotlessly pure. You see, Lord Rama was taken by Vishwamitra to Mithila. At the frontiers of Mithila, Vishwamitra told him, here is a village which is practically godforsaken now. Nobody lives here. Long before lived one great sage called Gautama Rishi here. But that's a long story which I am not reciting now. His wife Ahilya indulged with Indra, who came in the form of Gautama Rishi. Of course, Indra got a severe punishment for that. All over his body he got the eyes, and that's another pastime. But Gautama Rishi, seeing that his wife engaged in adultery, he cursed her to become a stone. She had become a stone there for many long years. When Lord Rama came, he put his lotus feet there. Just by the touch of his feet, immediately next moment Ahilya came out. So Ahilya Uddhar, he did that. That is the power of his dust of his lotus feet. And Krishna's lotus feet is explained here, like you see here. There's many symbols. Why his lotus feet are so pure? Because there's umbrella there, you see. The umbrella represents Lokanam Kirti Vardhanam. That is one of the names in Vishnu Sahasranama you read. Lokanam Kirti Vardhanam. Lord increases the fame of his devotees when one becomes his devotee. There was one devotee in our ISKCON movement, joined at the time of Prabhupada. He was actually a school dropout. Although he had a great ambition that I want to do, you know, join Harvard and study in Harvard. Harvard, who can join Harvard? You need to get a very high degree. He wanted to be one of the students of Harvard. He couldn't be. He was a school dropout. And then later on, somehow in the streets, he came across devotees and he met Prabhupada. He became initiated by Prabhupada. Started reading Prabhupada's books. And then gradually he picked up the spiritual knowledge so well. He started going out and talking lectures here, there. And he became very popular lecture presenter. So much so that once he got an invitation from Harvard. So then he went to Harvard University, where all the professors were sitting in the first row. And behind all the, there were 500 to 600 students sitting. The entire auditorium was full. So when he gave a lecture there on mind management, he gave, everybody applauded. He got a standing ovation. So when he came back to Prabhupada and he offered obeisances to Prabhupada and said, Prabhupada, I am a school dropout. Yet you made me qualified to go and deliver a lecture to professors of Harvard. And not only I became a student, I became teacher of the professors. This is called Lokanam Kirti Vardhana. How much Krishna increases fame of his devotee? You can see that. So, that is the umbrella. Umbrella is generally held above Indra's head. But if a person, ordinary person becomes devotee, he becomes as famous as Indra or anybody. Like Kanaka Das, he became pure devotee of Lord Udupi Krishna. Even today people talk about his pastime, correct, no? All over the world he is famous for his devotion. That Lord Krishna turned around to give him darshan, Udupi Krishna. Similarly, you find a lotus. Like a lotus is always pure. Even in the middle of muddy pool of water, the lotus is untouched. Like that, the devotee can remain pure by becoming Krishna's devotee in this world, following four regulative principles. He can be untouched by the impurity of the material world, like a lotus. Similarly, there is a thunderbolt, you will find. Oh, there is ankush. Ankush means a small stick for controlling an elephant. What is the meaning of this small stick? The devotee's mind is like an elephant. We all know how much the mind goes mad like an elephant. But Krishna's lotus feet has got a ankush or the stick to control elephant. So anybody becomes Krishna's devotee, his mind will become like a good elephant. A good elephant gives ashirvad. A good elephant carries log of wood. A good elephant can do painting of an elephant. I've shown you videos before, isn't it? A good elephant can carry Lord on his back. And a good elephant is tameable animal. It can be walked on the street. So in our Mayapur, we have an elephant procession every Saturday, carrying the Lord on the back. So our devotee's mind becomes like a good elephant by the ankush in Krishna's lotus feet, which controls our mind. There is a fish. Also, what is a fish? You know, Madan, who is actually Cupid, he makes all the young boys and girls mad in this world. Why? He's called as Madan Mohan. Madan. Mad means, his Madan is called Madan. The English word mad comes from Madan only. So, Madan makes everybody mad. Why? If a boy sees a beautiful girl, then he goes mad. Or a beautiful girl sees a beautiful boy, she goes mad. Therefore, they put a heart with an arrow pierced in it, correct, no? Who is piercing the arrow? Madan carries always a sugarcane bow and a flower arrow. Like that he puts. Then in anybody's heart he pierces, then they look at the member of the opposite sex and they go mad in this world. But when one becomes Krishna's devotee, at that time Madan becomes powerless. The reason is what? In Madan carries an insignia in which the flag, in which there is a symbol of fish. So when Madan goes to Dwaraka to make Krishna mad, that time seeing Krishna's beauty, he only faints and falls. And Krishna puts his foot on Madan's flag. So he subdues Madan. He has defeated the flag of Madan. And Madan's flag has got a fish which has come below Krishna's feet now. Correct, no? That means anybody who becomes Krishna's devotee, taking shelter of Krishna's lotus feet, they can conquer lusty desires, and they can transform lust into love. That's the meaning. So I can tell you about all other symbols, there are many more, but that's the point. That is, anavadyam means his lotus feet are spotless. Pranata dehinam papakarshanam trinacharanugam shriniketanam. Pranata dehinam papakarshanam trinacharanugam shriniketanam. Pani phanarpitam te padambujam krunakute shunaha krandihakshayam. Gopis are saying, my dear Lord, pranata dehinam papakarshanam. Anybody who takes shelter of your lotus feet, where is that? Anybody who takes shelter of your lotus feet, they decorate your feet with a tulasi and flowers, and they bow down to your lotus feet, papakarshanam. You destroy their mountain of sins to powder completely. Trina chara anugam. Trina means grass. Chara means that which eats the grass. Who is that? Cow. Anugam. You follow those animals which eat grass. Who are they? Cows. Yeah, Gopal. Trinachara anugam shrini ketanam. You are always carrying Lakshmi in your heart as a golden hair. And not only that, you dance on the hoods of Kaliya Sarpa, Kaliya serpent, and you make him humbled, and you made him humbled, and become, he became your devotee. That's the power of your lotus feet, they are saying. Okay, now one more word in that. Tasmat bhavantam anavadyam. Anavadyam we have finished. Next is anantaparam. What is the meaning of anantaparam? Anta means what? Ending. Ananta means unending. That means you never have birth. You know, you were never born and you will never die. You always exist. That's the meaning of anadikal se hai, anantikal tak rahenge. You are sarva karana karanam. Anadir adir govinda sarva karana karanam. What is the advantage of that? Say, for example, you are serving an IT company. You have a boss. You make sure you go before the boss comes to company, you reach there. After the boss leaves, you leave after him. Why? Can any of you say why you do that? To please the boss. If you impress the boss, he'll give you a promotion. 4 years you slogged. 9 to 9 you worked. Assume in the company. And you are thinking that boss is pleased with me. Now the promotion is coming. Now from GET eventually I'll become a team lead or something. So they will make me. And suddenly you find your boss gets transferred to some other place. Or he leaves the company and goes to another company. Next fellow comes, new fellow, he doesn't know who you are, you don't know who he is. Correct, no? In this way, in this world, the positions are temporary. Whereas when it comes to Krishna, he is Ananta. He will always be there. Even after you die and leave this body and go to the next body, he will come with you also. So the good work you do, he keeps it in permanent record. Indelible file he keeps it. Undepletable, indelible file. So he gives you fruits of your devotion service in the next life, following life, and many, many lifetimes. You may not even remember what you did in this life or the previous lives, but he will keep track of that. Such a master he is. Therefore, it's called Ananta. So there is no termination of time in his case. And para means what? Spatial termination. He is not limited by any jurisdiction at all. Yamaraj is limited by the jurisdiction of only the sinful living entities. He can't handle anybody. Similarly, the Prime Minister of India, his jurisdiction is India only. President of United States, his jurisdiction is United States only. They can't do anything with people in other country. Correct? No? They can only rule over the people of their own country. And there are smaller fellows also. Chief minister has only the state and like that. Whereas Krishna's jurisdiction is what? It spreads everywhere. Anantaparam, he says. Like for example, you see, his guru Sandipani Muni and his good wife asked, please, you are Supreme Personality of Godhead. We don't want to ask you any chotamata small things. We want our dead son back, who went to take bath in Prabhasakshetra ocean. And he got drowned in the ocean. He passed away. You bring our dead son back. And Krishna said, so be it. I can do it. So here he goes to that ocean. The Samudra Devata comes out and says, that, you know, sir, the son of your guru is not here. Then there is a Pancha Janavana Asura. So Krishna killed him, and then he got that shank also. Pancha Janya, we call it, you know. Okay, then he went to Yamaloka, Yama's abode. And then there he tells this verse to Yamaraj. Yamaraj comes running outside, offers obeisances to Krishna, hearing the blowing of the shank. When he heard the sound, he came running and offered obeisances. Oh my Lord, what brings you here? What do you want? Kuch seva dijiye, give me some seva. And Lord told this verse. Guru Putra Mihanitam Nija Karma Nibandhanam Anaya Swamaharaja Matshasana Puraskritaha. He's telling Guru Putra Mihanitam, my guru's son has come here to you. Maybe some past sinful reactions he may have, but don't worry. Anayasu Maharaj, bring him here immediately to me. And write his sinful reactions in my account, Krishna said. Just like a owner of a company may say, hey, remove 10 lakhs, remove 20 lakhs. Like that, Krishna took the son of his guru back, and the son of guru was relieved from Aham Tvam Sarva Papebhyo. He was relieved also and brought back. See, he's coming and giving to Guru and Guru Mata. He's giving back. That means Krishna can go to Yamaloka and bring somebody back, because Yama is also Krishna's servant only, ultimately. This is another pastime. This is a pastime where, it's a long story cut short, I will tell you. Once upon a time in Dwaraka, one Brahmana was yelling and screaming and shouting that, you know, what is the use of a king in this country? My three children have died one after another. And there's nobody to protect them. And as a Brahmana, I haven't committed any sin in this life. If a king can't protect an innocent person's child like this, what is the use of a king being there? What Kshatriyas have become powerless, you are telling. Hearing that, Arjuna said, wait a minute. You know, don't speak such ill words about Kshatriyas. I am also a Kshatriya. I am here. I will protect your fourth son. Three children have passed away. Don't worry. Fourth son can never pass. I am there. So when the Brahmana's wife was in the maternity ward, Arjuna took his bow and arrow and went round and round so that nobody can come to harm the child. But the Brahmana came running outside and said, hey Arjuna, all your talk is useless. Because you bada bada baat karta hai. You talked big things, but you didn't save my child. Fourth son also has died. And then Arjuna had taken a vow that if I am not able to save the child, then I will enter fire. And Arjuna had gone and asked Shiva. Even Shiva also couldn't get the child back. So Arjuna was wondering what to do. Then he was about to enter fire. Krishna said, Arjuna, don't you remember your friend? I am also there. At least you can ask me one word. So and then Arjuna asked, okay, tell me Krishna, anything, any possibility is there? What possibility? Done. Come with me. So Krishna took him in his chariot. And then straight they went to the end of this Brahmanda, and they broke through the shell of Brahmanda, crossed the Brahmanda, and went to the Paravyoma. And Paravyoma is the place where there is effulgence of the Brahma Jyoti. When the horses saw their effulgence, they turned their face away because of bright light of the Brahman. So there Mahavishnu was lying, and from his body all the universes were emanating. No? There when they saw Mahavishnu, so at that time as soon as Mahavishnu saw Krishna and Arjuna, he became so happy. And Arjuna saw Mahavishnu because he had heard about Mahavishnu before. And immediately offered obeisances. Oh, this is that great master from whom all the universes are generated. So Arjuna offered obeisances. But Mahavishnu, seeing Krishna, he smiled and said, "My Lord, I know that other than you, no one else can come and take these four Brahmanas' children. I only stole those four children and brought them here. Especially I wanted your darshan. Therefore I brought them here. Now I'm handing them over to you back." He gave back. And then Krishna and Arjuna took the four sons and went back. On the way back, while riding the chariot, Krishna told this sloka to Arjuna. Maddarshanartam te bala hritastena mahatmana viprartam yeshate krishno matsamipam nachanyatha. Read the translation.
Krishna told Arjun, "It was to see me that he, Mahavishnu, the Supreme Soul, stole the children. He believed only on a Brahmana's behalf will Krishna come to see me, not otherwise."
Which means even Mahavishnu wants whose darshan? Krishna's darshan. Because Mahavishnu is expansion of Krishna only, but even he is eager to take darshan of Krishna. In this way you will find he could go to Mahavishnu Loka, he could go to Yama Loka, now one more Loka he went, you see here. This is one day very early morning, Nanda Baba went to take a bath, probably 2 o'clock or 2:30 like that, in the Yamuna. So Varuna Deva's attendants, they saw that, hey, in an odd hour, some man is coming and taking bath, because there is a time for taking the early morning bath, a particular time, like Brahma Muhurta time. Even much before that, if somebody caught up and he was taking. So they caught him and they took him to Varuna Loka. This is Varuna Loka, Varuna Deva sitting. So they didn't know who is Nanda Baba, what is his position. And then Krishna went to Varuna Loka also to bring his father back. See? Read this.
Seeing Lord Krishna came, Varuna worshipped Lord Krishna and spoke as follows. "I have achieved the perfection of my life. One can transcend the material existence by accepting your lotus feet. Obeisances to you, absolute truth with no trace of illusion, the source of creation."
So Nanda Baba was amazed to see this. Hey, my son is being worshipped by Varuna Deva. What is his position? What is my son's position? See, Nanda Baba is sitting and amazed. And the one who is standing is who? That is Varuna Deva. With folded palms, he is worshipping Krishna, you see. And then Krishna brought his father back. So, how many places Krishna went, I told you? Last one was Varuna Deva. Varuna Loka. Before that, he went to Mahavishnu Loka. Before that, he went to Yama Loka. So, is there any jurisdiction for Krishna? Therefore, he is saying Anantaparam. Ananta means for unending amount of time, Krishna will be knowing about you. And there is no jurisdiction for him. He can bring you from anywhere. He can protect you in all places. Because he is the master of everyone and everything. Tasmat bhavantam anavadyam anantaparam sarvajnam ishwaram. That is the word sarvajnam. Read it.
If we serve someone other than the Supreme Personality of Godhead, our so-called master may forget our service or become ungrateful. Therefore, Lord Krishna is described here as Sarvajnam, omniscient. He can never forget the service of his devotee and therefore he is never ungrateful. In fact, it is said that Lord Krishna does not remember the faults of his devotees, but only the sincere service they have rendered.
Yeah. There was one devotee called, one king called Muchukunda. He was sleeping in a gufa after fighting for the side of demigods against the demons. Demons were defeated and demigods were very happy. Demigods asked him, "What boon you want?" They told him, "We can give you any boon on earth, Rite Kaivalyam," they said, "except liberation. We can give you anything else," they said. So Muchukunda said, "I don't need anything from you. I am a devotee of Supreme Lord. I am already happy. But there is one boon I want from you. Now I am going to take rest now. War is over now. Nobody, especially Indra, should not wake me up. In case any demons come back to attack you all, don't trouble me. For last so many days I have been doing night out. My eyes are bloodshot. I am very tired. So I'm going to sleep now. And I want to have a long sleep. Just like boys say after their examinations. Isn't it take a long sleep? So he said, give me a boon that any fellow will come and wake me up in the middle of my sleep. If I look at them, they should be burned down to ashes. Like that he asked for a boon. Demigod said, so be it, don't worry. None of us will develop, and Indra also knows about the boon, so he will also not disturb you. Gave him. So he went into a gufa, Muchukunda gufa. And he covered himself with a blanket and went to sleep. And Krishna was chased by one Kalayavana, who was a great sinner. He had brought some Savanakshavanis, I think. So he came attacking Mathura. Krishna didn't want to be touched by him. So Krishna fled. And that Kalayavana chased behind him. Kalayavana was running behind Krishna. And Krishna entered this gufa of Muchukunda. So it was a dark cave. Kalayavana saw, where is this fellow Krishna hiding? So he saw one fellow was sleeping with a covered blanket. And Krishna went and stood on the head side of Muchukunda. And on the feet side, this fellow came. Who? Kalayavan. Seeing that, hey, this fellow is sleeping peacefully. You know, he came running into cave and covering with the blanket, and he has gone to Krishna, has gone to sleep. I think he is thinking, I can't detect him. So taking his leg, gave a big kick on him. When he gave a kick, Muchukunda took off the blanket and said, who woke me up? Then he looked at Kalayavana, and Kalayavana was burned down to ashes. And then only skeleton remained. Next moment he turned towards Krishna. When he saw Krishna's form, you know, his tej or the power of his eyes became diminished. So you will read that section in Bhagavatam. He's telling, my dear Lord, my eyes could burn Kalayavana down, but when I look at you, you know, your body is so effulgent that my effulgence is like a glowworm's effulgence, and your effulgence like sun's effulgence. Who are you? Ko Bhavan? Iti Samprapto. He said, Giri Kandare. Like that he said in this gufa in the forest. How did you arrive here? Ko Bhavan? And then he asked, are you Vibhavasav? Are you sun god? Are you moon god? Are you Agnideva? Who is so effulgent? Who are you? And I am seeing that your feet are not standing on the ground. You are standing on a lotus. Probably you are that Supreme Personality of Godhead. I am a little confused. Please tell me who you are. And then Muchukunda told about himself, that I come from Ikshvaku dynasty, but I am not such a great king like my ancestors. And then you tell me who you are. And then Lord smiled and said, Muchukunda, you are my pure devotee. Prarthitam prachuram purvam. In your purva janma, you did so much bhakti for me. You had an intense longing to see my darshan, but you couldn't see. Now I have come to give you darshan. Like that he said. That means sarvagyam, you always, Lord remembers. See, if you have done your homework in doing chanting Hare Krishna, following four regs, even next life you are sleeping, Lord will come and wake you up and give you darshan. Because already you have done your part. Lord will not forget, even he forgot. But Lord will not forget what his devotee has done. That is the meaning of sarvajnam. On the other hand, you will see, you know, let us assume that you are working in a company, you did a lot of wonderful work, and boss is very convinced, he is very happy with you. When the time of promotion comes, he is thinking of giving you. But some mischievous colleague in your office goes to your boss, and in Hindi they say, no, kaan bardena, they say, no. Something he says like that about you. Oh boss, this man, you are thinking so good about him, he is so bad, he does this against you, he does this against you, some lies he speaks. Then boss will say, oh, like that, I never knew this, nobody told me. Then instead of giving you promotion, he may give promotion to someone else because he got misled by somebody's mischievous rumor mongering. Correct, no? Is he sarvajnam, your boss? He's not all-knowing. But Krishna is all-knowing. Can somebody cheat Krishna by telling something wrong about you if that wrong is not true? Will Krishna get cheated? Rather than punish you, he'll punish that fellow. Hey rascal, you are drinking, you can cheat me, I am sarvajna, I know everything. He knows your past record, he knows your present record, he has everything about you, A to Z. Even you may not know about yourself many things which Krishna knows. That's the meaning of his sarvajna. Such a wonderful master that we don't have to worry at all. Only you have to be honest with him. You can't cheat him. Because he's all-knowing. You can't cheat him. If you are honest with him, you know, see this this devotee, Surdas or Billo Mangal, he is blind. And he is sitting in the Vrindavan forest, you know, playing veena, playing this, what do you call it, chaplakate, what do you call that? Chipla, you call it, yeah. Playing that, he is singing Krishna's names with great ananda, great bhakti paravash. And he doesn't even know, you know, whether Krishna is hearing or not. He is joyfully singing, but see, Krishna is coming and sitting next to him with great interest, he is hearing. Because he is all knowing. His loving glance falls on those sincere devotees who faithfully worship him with great devotion and sincerity. And actually seeing Krishna's sarvajna nature, devotees become thoroughly honest. Because they know that here is a person who can see in and out of me. You know, I am naked in front of him. I have no power to hide anything to him. Therefore, we can repent before him. We can beg for forgiveness from him. We can admit our faults to him. We can surrender to him. We can express our readiness to accept any type of punishment he may want to give us. Or if he wished us to protect us, he can protect us. So he's all-knowing personality. So, and Ishwaram. Sometimes a person may be knowing also many things good about you, but he is powerless fellow. There are people like that, isn't it? Like, you know, in your office, your boss didn't give you promotion. You go to complain to another person. Sir, this is my track record. If this fellow is not giving promotion, somebody has filled his ears with wrong things. He will say, yeah, I understand. You are a good person. I am good. You are good. Everybody is good. Only problem is, I have no power, you know, to tell that person to change. You know, I have my limitations. People are powerless. Whereas Krishna is Ishwaram. Not only Ishwaram. Ishwaraha Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha Viseno. He is the supreme Ishwara. There is no Ishwara equal to him or greater than him. It's called Asama Urdhva. Asama Urdhva. There is nobody above him, nobody equal to him. Mattaparadaram Nanyat Kinchidasti Dhananjaya. Krishna says, no. Matta parataram na anyat. Beyond me there is nobody. I am the ultimate, he says that. Nobody equal to me or beyond me. So, if Krishna knows that you are sincere, honest, nobody can come your way. For example, you know, Ajamila was caught by the Yamapash. But as soon as he chanted, Narayana! Next moment, pat! Immediately Vishnudas came and cut the ropes of Yama. Who is more powerful? The Lord appearing in the form of holy name is powerful, or Yamaraja's noose is powerful? Holy name, yeah. You can imagine if Krishna's name is so powerful, if Krishna only comes there personally, who can do what? Everybody is rendered powerless in front of him. You know, one time there was an Banasura, you know. And there are others also. There are many other asuras. One asura, Banasura only got Shiva also, no? On his side. Shiva sent Shiva Jvara. And then Krishna sent Vishnu Jvara. So Vishnu Jvara is very cold. Shiva Jvara is very hot. Shiva Jvara came to burn. Vishnu Jvara sent. Shiva Jvara started shivering. It's very, very cold. Later on, after the war was over, Shiva came and offered obeisance. Said, my dear Lord, poor fellow Banasura, my devotee, I came to help him. You know, I have nothing against you. So you will see that there is no battle that Krishna has lost. You will not find. He will always be the winner, whether it be Kurukshetra battlefield. And in case he is leaving the battlefield and running away, that's for a special work. Like Rukmini's letter had come. So he left Jarasandha's battle and left. But Jarasandha laughed. He told his friends, Shishupal and other people, hey, do you know, Shishupal, now that Krishna has taken Rukmini and married her and gone, don't cry as if your wife is taken away. She is not your wife. You have not even married her. You are aspiring to marry her. You lost her. Don't worry. Don't lose your hope. Even I drove him away in a battle. Do you know that he saw my chariot and he ran away, Krishna? Others told him, sir, but we heard Krishna defeated you 17 times. Is that also true? No. That's a small detail. Don't talk about such things. You know, talk about how I drove Krishna, he was telling. So only once Krishna is called Ranchod Rai. You know why? Because he went for a very important work to Dwaraka to receive the Brahmana who had come on behalf of Rukmini. Otherwise, you will find always Krishna is supreme controller. Like here you see, he is lifting the Govardhan Hill and giving shelter to all the Vajabhasis. He can give the best shelter. He is Ishwaram, supreme controller. You know, when all else fails, Lord Govinda is the only hope. Like here you see, Draupadi saw five powerful lion-like husbands are all sitting with hung heads. Big Kuru elders like Bhishma Pitamaha and Dhritarashtra and Dronacharya and Vidura, none of them are taking any action. She is in the middle of the Sabha like a tender sparrow, and Dushasana is like a man, like an elephant trying to disrobe her in the public. What can such a poor woman do? Seeing the situation completely unfavorable to her, she raised her arms and cried out, "Hey Krishna, hey Govinda, hey Gopijanvallabha, hey Dwarakavasin," like that she cried. There you find immediately Krishna supplied unlimited sari. So that is the meaning of Ishwaram, supreme controller. Nobody can stop him from protecting his devotee. Read it.
A further disadvantage in serving anyone besides Krishna is that when we are in danger, our master may not be able to protect us. If we take shelter of our nation, that nation may be destroyed in war. If we take shelter of our family, they may also die. And as described in the Vedic literature, even the demigods are sometimes defeated by the demons. But since Lord Krishna is described here as Ishwar or the supreme controller, there is no danger of his being overcome or even impeded by any other power. Thus, Lord Krishna's promise of protection to his devotee is eternally valid.
Yeah. There was one meeting happening amongst all demigods. Lord Shiva had gone along with his good wife Parvati also. They were sitting and Shiva had eyes closed in the Dhyana Mudra in the meeting. Others are all talking. So Parvati suddenly shook Shiva and said, you know, she said, do you know your devotee Ravana, his life is in danger. There is a big war going on in Lanka now. It seems today is the day Lord Rama has planned to kill Ravana. And he is your famous devotee. So, what about saving him? Are you making any plans? Shiva said, just forget it. I am not going to save him. Vinashakale Vipreeta Buddhi. So, he gave up in protection of Ravana. And then he told, how can I protect him? He has gone against my master. Lord is master of everybody, including me. And he has gone against him. He has acted irreligiously. He has to suffer. So he gave up. Now, in the same manner, somebody may take shelter of any demigod and they may not be protected at the time of dire need. But as far as Krishna is concerned, he has no other master above him to serve. If somebody takes shelter of Krishna, he will protect in two ways. If you are righteous, then Krishna will do everything to protect you. For example, Prahlad was protected. You know, he protected Ambarish Maharaj. Like that he will protect. And if you are going wrong, he will give a slap and bring you to the right path. That also you will see. If somebody does wrong, like, you know, Dhruva Maharaj was about to embark a war against Yakshas. So Swayambhuvanu came and advised him to walk the right path, and he walked. And Arjuna was about to walk a wrong path by giving up battlefield of Kurukshetra. But Krishna himself gave him advice. So Krishna's beauty is, if his devotees do anything wrong, he will correct them and rectify them. And if they are doing right, he will protect them. You will see that. So he is a supreme controller. Last point here. Akunta Vikunta Dishnyam. Krishna's spiritual world is a beautiful place. Everybody is hale and healthy and young. Nobody gets old there. Nobody gets diseases there. And no kind of suffering can enter there. The six whips of the material nature, like Kshut, Pipas, Shoka, Moha, Jara, Mrityu, they are all absent there. Kshut means hunger, Pipas means thirst, and Jara, Mrityu means old age and death, Shoka, Moha means lamentation and illusion, all are absent there. Tribhita Tap is also absent there, Adhyatmika, Adhibhautika, Adhidevika. Fourfold problems of Janma, Mrityu, Jara, Vedi are absent. And Shadripus, like Kamakrodha, Madhulobha, Matsari there. They will not trouble anyone there. In this way, his abode is completely free from all suffering. Please read it.
Lord Krishna has an eternal abode called Vaikuntha, and that abode is never disturbed by anything. The faithful servants...
Somebody may say, no, Krishna's abode is Goloka, we may say. See, all the spiritual planets put together are called as Vaikuntha planets. In that, the topmost planet is Goloka. And below that, there is Vaikuntha. Then there is Saket also. And then there are many other Vishnu Lokas also. They are all called, together they are called Vaikuntha planets, we call it, in Paravyoma. in the spiritual sky. Yeah. Yes.
The faithful servants of Lord Krishna will certainly go back to Godhead, back home for an eternal life of bliss and knowledge in the personal abode of the Lord. However, since even the demigods, and what to speak of insignificant human beings, are subject sooner or later to annihilation, what ultimate benefit can be derived from serving
them?
So
there is no other worthy master to surrender other than Krishna. Actually, demigods are not only the 33 crore demigods, even the cinema heroes, heroines are also like demigods, Prabhupada says. Even the famous politicians are like demigods because people wag their tail to get some post from them. So they are also called as chota demigods. But ultimately all the so-called demigods will be finished. Krishna is the only master who will eternally live, and he is the only one who can eternally offer you shelter. Nobody can offer you eternal shelter. You all know that in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, if you worship any demigod, what he says? Trai vidyamam soma papu tapapa yagnya irishtva swargatim prartayante te punyam asadya surendra lokam ashtanti divyan divideva bhogan te tam bhaktva swarga lokam vishalam kshine punye martya lokam vishanti evam trai dharma manu prapanna gata agatam kama kama alavante. These two verses he says, those people who offer worship to the demigods, they go to Surendra Lokam. They drink soma juice there. They live long life there. Often they eat basmati rice, molten ghee, very nice. Apsaras are singing, dancing. Nandanandana garden, very nice atmosphere. And they live a sattvic life, very nice life. And then when their punya gets over, they all come back. So the demigods, the benedictions, and the demigods, and the demigod followers, everyone will be finished off at the time of pralaya. Whereas Krishna says, yasa sarvesha bhuteshu nashyatsu na vinashyati. The Vaikuntha planets will never be destroyed when all the material universes will be destroyed, he says. So therefore one should return back to Krishna's abode where one will never have to face any kind of inevitability, danger or suffering or anything. Okay, now let's take some questions now. Srinivas Balasubramanian Prabhu is asking, I am working as a legal manager of NBFC company. Kindly guide me how to remain detached or detach myself from workspace, but at the same time not neglect my work. So you should hear the lecture which I spoke 3-4 days ago, Attitude Towards Profession. Go to live.radheshyamdas.com. In that Behavioral Science for Youth, you click that box. Inside the box, look for the topic, Attitude Towards Profession. I have elaborately spoken on this. Yeah. Okay, Kesha Kumar was asking, is it good to do higher studies as after BE we are getting less salary and want to contribute to Lord Krishna? Counselors don't recommend this as they want us to do seva. Please help how we can convince and manage ourselves and tell a message to our counselors. Okay. See, I have seen many boys in the final year, they write GATE in a very ineffective way. I have seen that because they are sometimes preaching. Along with that, they are also trying to study for GATE and they study half-heartedly because they have to study the college subjects also. On the other hand, I have seen boys who they preach well, they study their final year subjects well, they do the project well, everything. Once the study is over, they go to Hyderabad, I think 6 months or something. Solid coaching they take and they get 99, 99.3, 99.4, like that they get. And they crack and get into IIT. So if Kesha Kumar Prabhu has an interest to go for higher studies, I would tell you that to do a solid job of getting a very high score in GATE and then get into IIT or NIT, and then that degree will fetch you a very good job and it can be a more cool job for you. In case you are able to get a good rank in GATE and get into IIT, all our IITs have student centers available. Voice centers are there all across the country, wherever you go. And NITs also, IITs and NITs. And then you can study, you can stay in the center, you can take prasad, you can also attend the programs and everything. And then when you graduate, you get a very good job placement. And then you can devote more time to Krishna, it will be a good paying job for you. But if you are planning to do higher study, you have to really, really get good score. Otherwise, I have seen boys who do a half-hearted study for GATE. That doesn't work so well. So then in that case, your counselors will be happy that you are helping them to preach till the final year and then graduate from your this thing and then take out one more year for qualifying for GATE if you can. That is one suggestion where I have seen people cracking quite well. Next question. If not able to meet deadlines, quality is not good in given time. What to improve at? Intelligence doesn't come. Ideas are not coming. What to do? Okay. If you're not able to meet deadlines, quality definitely reduces because you have to keep the deadline. Correct, no? Yeah. So what I would do if I were in your situation in any field, I would meet the deadline with less quality. And then in the course of time, I will learn some skills and I will equip myself to know how I can gradually improve my quality from one level to the higher level in anything. For example, you have the chanting also. In the morning, you are doing chanting. You know, we have a couple of hours allotted for chanting. So in that time, we chant. Many times, boys tell me that, Prabhu, if the chanting quality is not good, I feel like chanting one more round again. You can do, but how many of us have so much time to imagine today 8 rounds are not good. Can you chant 8 rounds more? So it becomes challenging sometimes. So what I would do, whatever best quality you are able to offer within the deadline, you do it. And then keep making an effort to improve. Like if it is chanting, I would read more chanting books. I would consult devotees and ask questions. I would try to improve. In the same manner, in your company job or in your spiritual life, quality improvement is a gradual thing. Suddenly it won't come overnight. Be patient. And equip yourself with more skills. That's what I would say. And consult people. Three things you can do, I will tell you. Make step-by-step quality progress. Like watermelon, you cannot eat like this. Cut it into pieces, step-by-step. Small progress you make, little. That is one thing I can tell you. Second thing I can tell you, meet people who are very successful in doing that in a short time and in a very effective way with very high quality. Make friendship with them regularly and then go and ask them, learn from them, be humble and they will be very happy to share with you their ideas and everything. Correct, no? And third one is you cultivate skills in that field. More skills. When you have more skills, you can do the same service better. Three things you can do. But the question is not related to the class. Can you please tell whether there will be English classes from July 14th? There will be only one English class, which is Chaitanya Charitamrita, between 5:30 to 6:45. And then 6:45 immediately Kirtan will start. Our team will do Kirtan. And then 7 to 8:30 I am planning to do Demons and Vrindavan Leela in Hindi language. Only those two will be there. This Behavioral Science for Youth, we gave enough time for doing several topics as well as question answers also. Now my mailbox also is over-flooding with many people writing questions. I have 300-400 mails. On an average, I reply 40 mails a day. Now I am replying 70-80 mails a day. So I also have a human limit. I may not be able to catch up so much because I am getting new acquaintances of people now writing from various places. So therefore, my suggestion to you would be, you are in Hyderabad, you have very good devotees like Tarun Mohan Prabhu, Achyut Gopal Prabhu and Sarashamni Prabhu. If you go to ISKCON Abids, and also you can put Madhapur ISKCON, ISKCON Madhapur. If you put, there is a very nice center there, flourishing center. And I will be coming to Hyderabad once lockdown is lifted up. I will be coming to Hyderabad every month for 1 week minimum. So when I come, I can meet you personally. You are in Vishakhapatnam, it seems. So this one. Can you please tell whether there will be... it is Vishakhapatnam. Okay. You are in Vizag. Okay. You can also go to temple, Vizag temple. There is Sambha Prabhu and Nithai Sevini Mataji. They are very intelligent devotees. You can consult them also. You can, in case you have question, you can write to me at voicemedia.pune@gmail.com. voicemedia.pune@gmail.com. You write your questions and maybe I can reply you gradually. Yeah. Amanpu is asking, in this lockdown we are facing difficult situations related to, what is that? Fired from job, correct, yeah. Sitting at home, unemployed, shops are closed, source of income is reduced. So how to see the good hands of Krishna for all of these situations and how to do bhakti enthusiastic in a condition when we are completely materially imbalanced. Yeah, I understand. Actually, Prabhupada says danger must be there because we have put ourselves in a dangerous position. Like that he says. We have ourselves put in a the material world. We were in spiritual world very happily with Krishna, but now we have come here. So we should be ready for both. When you are going in an ocean, in a ship, sometimes it's calm, sometimes there is storm. So both are possible. So right now, in case somebody is fired from job, they don't have a job, parents may be very worried, beta, you don't have a job, how will you survive in this world? So you have to give them confidence that I am a qualified man. I have so many years of experience. I have a good degree. Now there is a little bit of trouble because of the COVID situation, but it's not going to go on forever. The nature of material world is there is suffering for a while. Then it will go off. See, plague came in this world. It's not that plague is there all the time. Plague went away. In fact, SARS, it came two, three years ago it came. You know, that was another virus similar to COVID. Stayed for a while, went away. They say that this also will go away by September, October, they are saying it will go away. So give your assurance to parents, don't worry. If one job is gone, you can always get another one. In case you are trying for two, three jobs, you are not getting them, go for learning some skills. Because if you possess skills, if somebody needs your skill, they will easily want to employ you. Huh? Yeah. And also, you do your spiritual life now that you are getting time now. And you give confidence to parents. Tell them not to unnecessarily worry. You are a devotee. If you only worry, how much they will have confidence. You are a devotee. You should know that this is a part of life. Prabhupada says, even for devotees, there will be upheavals in the material world. We have to live with it. Our main goal is this. In fair weather or foul weather, my devotional service should not go down. My chanting should not go down. Reading should not go on. Let me protect my devotional service. And then let me tolerate the foul weather. Pray to Krishna for strength. Call devotees and take guidance from different devotees. You can do that. Regarding spiritual duty, we told in Shri Krishna study that if one does four things, hearing Prabhupada half an hour to 1 hour, read Prabhupada books 1 to 2 hours, keep away from temptation of Maya, strictly adhere to Prabhupada's program, then Prabhupada will not allow us to deviate. Yes. And then what activities come under Prabhupada's program? Is it only morning program? Yes, that's a morning program. Plus, apart from morning program, Harinam Sankirtan, going out in the streets, and book distribution. Prabhupada wanted these things very desperately. He said, you are actually giving me life by distributing books, Prabhupada said. When Prabhupada was very sick, he would be lying down. But when books course were coming, he would sit down immediately to know how many books were distributed. So if you distribute Prabhupada books and join and take part in Harinam Sankirtan and attend the whole morning program, then you are doing Prabhupada's programs. Second question? Okay. How can we follow this at home visits where full morning program is a little difficult? Okay. At least one of the things you can do is to sleep early and rise before other home members wake up, like, 4 o'clock or something. They all get up at 6:37, they get up. So by the time your morning program is over, Only thing is if you are also keeping awake till midnight, talking to them, then it will be difficult. So on the day when you go, you may talk late. That's all right. But then eventually you should tell them, I'm used to sleeping early. So I'll talk to you during the daytime. Anyway, all day I'm here only. So you sleep early, get up early. And if you don't want to disturb them, go to the terrace. And you can chant in the terrace. You can have a traveling altar, one A4 size altar. Just to stick it to the glue tack and you can do a one-man Mangalarati on the moonlit night. Early morning, Brahma Muhurtam time and you will become powerful. Srinivasan Balasubramaniam Prabhu. It is said that in Vaikuntha there is a lot of opulence and less of Madhurya. Does Lord Vishnu allow his devotees to involve in any pastimes in Vaikuntha? Or the Lord Dwarapala do not allow devotees to come near Lord Vishnu and touch him like Lord Krishna does in Krishna Loka, where Lord Krishna forgets himself that he is Supreme Being. Allow his devotees to be in friend, servant, beloved pants. Okay. You see, in Vaikuntha, there is a lot of reverential relationship. Just like yourself, Srinivas Prabhu, when you go to your college, you meet the principal or you meet your teachers. What type of relation you have? Naturally, one of us, good morning, sir. And you stand at a little distance away and you, please may come in, sir. Now you take permission. That is reverential. That's the way relationship is there. When you come home, you may put hand around your father's neck. You may joke with your father also if you have intimate relationship. If your father also has a very jovial nature, you can joke with him, he can joke with you like that. So there is an intimacy at home and formality in the office, isn't it? So like that only Vaikuntha is like that. And people in Vaikuntha don't feel that, hey, Goloka people are so intimate and we are unable to be intimate. They never feel like that. In fact, for them with intimacy they have problem. Like in South India I have seen many people like gurus and other people to be more or less formal. Formal behavior they appreciate. If you become little jovial, they feel uneasy because they are brought up in a formal setting. Even Brahma and Shiva, they want Lord Vishnu to always be majestic in nature. Therefore it is said in Vaikuntha, Lord Vishnu is more beautiful than Lakshmi also, it is said. Whereas in Goloka, Radharani is more beautiful than Krishna. And Prabhupada gives the reason why. Because Shiva, Brahma and other devatas want Lord Vishnu to maintain his supreme position even beyond Lakshmi also. Therefore Lord accepts majestic position. Similarly, in some homes you will see the husband has a majestic role and wife is very, very submissive. And whatever you say, she will run and do everything. Her children, everybody is afraid. Father is like a military officer. You have seen that? Some homes. In other homes, the husband is completely like a child. And a wife will shout at him, yell at him. Children will be climbing on his shoulder. Papa, you know, you are not in. You have seen that? Yeah. And the papa will be such an innocent father. You know, he will be completely controlled by everybody. You have seen that, no? So similarly, Vaikuntha and Goloka is easily understandable, the situation. So in case you have a desire to have an intimate relationship, don't worry, you will go to Goloka. You will go. And Lord Vishnu has his own way of dealing intimately. His intimate dealings are like a smile at his devotee. And so there are certain intimate pastimes of Lord Vishnu also you will read. But the intimacy doesn't cross a certain border. In Krishna's case, it's much more intimate. Yeah. According to your own eternal relationship, you will reach a particular spiritual planet and you will get that association of the Lord accordingly. After disappearance of Lord, Abhishek was asking, after disappearance of Lord, their queens are kidnapped by some queen, even leaves their body. Why they gone through such terrible situation even though they were all great sages of incarnation? What happened with kidnapped queens? Okay. That is mentioned in Prabhupada quotes from one Varaha Puran. The Puran says that once upon a time there were apsaras in heaven. They saw Ashtavakra Muni coming there and they all cooked for him and he ate nice prasad. He appreciated all the apsaras and told them, oh, this prasadam was so delicious. I bless all of you girls that in your next life you will get Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna as your husband. Oh, they all again offered obeisance and thanked the sage. Thank you, thank you. After that the sage was leaving. So when he was walking, his body had twists in 8 places. So his body would move like this when he would be walking. And all the girls by nature, they used to laugh. So then they laughed. Huh? So when the sage saw, turned around and said, hey, you are all laughing at me? Then he said, you will all be kidnapped by thieves. Huh? You know, when you become alone, you will be kidnapped by thieves. Then they became frightened. They ran back to him and offered obeisance and said, please don't curse us like this. He said, no, sorry, I can't take back the curse. But I can modify the curse, he said. How will you modify it? Then he said, your husband Krishna only will become infidel covered men, in the form of thieves. And then he will only steal all of you. So don't worry, he said. Then they became very happy. So when Krishna ascended to his abode, when Arjuna was returning from Dwaraka to Vrindavan, bringing some of the queens, so those covered men who came on the way, they stole the gold and silver and diamond, and some of the queens were taken. So those covered men were also Krishna's expansions only. That is explained in the Purana. If you read the Bhagavatam purport, one of the purports Prabhupada explains that. You will read that. Yeah. That is another pastime of the Lord. Lord Krishna, to obey his Guru Sandipani Muni's wish, Guru Dakshina brought back from Yamaloka also. Also when his mother Yashoda asked Lord Krishna to bring back her sons who were killed by Kamsa. That is Devaki. He did the same. But why did he not bring back his nephew Abhimanyu? There is a reason for that. Abhimanyu was son of Somadeva. So Somadeva, when he was asked whether his son can be taken for the Lord's Leela on earth, so he told the demigods that you can take my son. But he called his son and said, but I want you to be back when you become 16 years. And son agreed, okay, I'll play a part in Lord Krishna's pastimes on earth. and I'll be back at the age of 16. And therefore, Krishna wanted to keep the promise to Soma, who gave his son for including in the this thing in his Leela here. So he arranged for Abhimanyu to be sent back. That is the reason given in Mahabharata. Yeah. Mahalakshma is asking, thank you so much for giving wonderful classes. My question is, most of the time I am drowned in my own anarthas and other material problems. How to experience always cheerful in Krishna consciousness? Yeah. So I'll be speaking on demons in Vrindavan Leela. Only thing is, it'll be in Hindi. I'm starting tomorrow evening. If you hear those lectures, you will see many of them will talk about the anartha nivritti, learning from the Vrindavan pastimes of Krishna. Also, I recently spoke Shaky to Steady seminar and overcoming unwanted habits. These are available in our Radhesham Das devotional videos. In a playlist. Yeah, if you go to playlist, you will find out. So you can hear them. Actually, we all have to work on one another. You are not the only one. All of us, everybody has to work, and we will gradually get better and better. Chaitanya Prabhu is asking, does each and every cell in human body has a separate soul? No. Actually, in this body, there are millions of souls, but there is only one prominent soul. Just like you are living in a house now, Chaitanya is living in a house. In the same house, there are rats, there are ants, there are cockroaches. Isn't it? Different creatures live, but they are not the owner of those. You are the owner. Similarly, you are the prominent soul. Other souls are just living in the body, in different parts of the body, as a part of. Some of them will give you trouble also. Some of them will do good also for you. Some bacteria are called good bacteria. Some are called bad bacteria. So they have been kept for some purpose. How many more questions? Really? Okay. Since Krishna is self-sufficient and non-dependent, what are the reasons soul exists along with Krishna since time immemorial? Also, can a soul be destroyed? No, soul is never destroyed. The soul and Krishna are existing just like parents and children exchanging love. There is no other purpose. Actually, we are part and parcel of Krishna. So, we have similar quality like Him. So, we have nice exchange of love through the pastimes. Just like any father and mother living at home, imagine they have a big, big bungalow. There are no children. It will be boring, isn't it? Imagine there are 2 dozen children all wearing colorful dresses of different shapes and sizes and forms. They are all running. The house becomes very bustling with activity. So, the spiritual world is filled with living entities exchanging love with the Lord in various pastimes. Kumar was asking, according to Manusamhita, what kind of suffering or punishment is given for one who eats food that is not offered to Lord? Actually, Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita that the food which is not offered to Him is sin, He says. Sin means it's disobedience to God. So, Krishna doesn't mention about what is the exact punishment. But actually, once you know that food should be offered, then you should not avoid offering. One should always offer. But most people are ignorant, they don't know. Therefore, the sinful reactions make them suffer. But once you know, now you are a devotee, you know, start offering very strictly. Is soul present in atom? No, soul is not present in atom. Only super soul is present. Without the presence of super soul, even electrons cannot rotate. All actions take place because of presence of super soul. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says there are no rules for chanting, and there are also some verses which say that even you neglectfully say Hare Krishna, your sense of millions of lifetimes will be gone. It has also great effect. But generally we study some verses say that we have to chant without offenses attentively. Yeah, why it says like that? Say for example, even if you chant inattentively, immediately you have got entry into devotional service. For example, in Vrindavan you go, outside the Balram Hall, there are crowds of people for prasadam. And then you are wondering, my Lord, first pankti, second pankti, third pankti is over, prasadam shouldn't get over. So one time I was also in the crowd, we were all having coupon. So one boy said, Prabhuji, I purchased the coupon, but I'm wondering prasadam will get over. So the man at the gate asked him, you have coupon or not? He said, yes. If you have coupon, you'll get full prasad, assured. Hai na coupon aapke paas? Pura plate mil gaya aapko, he said. Uska matlab kya hai? You don't get filtered immediately. They have to clean the hall, they have to put the new this thing, and then they'll put the leaf, and then you have to go inside, you have to sit. Then you will get, but the coupon means you are, similarly once you have chanted even neglectfully holy name, your spiritual life has started now. Then you will get better and better eventually. That's the meaning of that. Please clarify this, Prabhu. And also, what about English classes from tomorrow? Will it be there? No. Today is the last class. Tomorrow onwards, only Chaitanya Charitamrita I am doing, which is between 5:30 to 6:45. I am doing Madhya Leela. Sarvabhattacharya deliverance is going on. If you wish to join, any of you English speaking devotees, you want to join English class, it's 5:30 to 6:45. You are most welcome. That's a everyday class except Wednesday and Sunday. Wednesday also it's there, no? Wednesday it's there, and on Friday I answer questions. In case you couldn't ask some question, you can ask there. Every Friday I have devoted for questions, 5:30 to 6:45, question answer session. And Sunday I do other program, you all know. So you can join 5:30, 6:45, okay? Currently, I am not staying in center, but I am listening to your behavioral science sessions. How frequently can I take each session? I just don't want to listen, but also apply too. Yeah, you can decide your pace, because you hear the lecture, make some bullet point notes and apply. On average, if you hear a couple of lectures in a week, two or three, then you will get time to think and apply also. Now in lockdown, you may get more time, so two, three you can hear easily in a week. Why Krishna didn't give the knowledge of the soul to his spiritual master when he asked for his son? His spiritual master, Sandipani Muni, is a very, very great soul. How do you think he became guru of Krishna? They are all very intimate associates. Whoever becomes mother and father of Krishna, guru of Krishna, Sudama, the friend of Krishna, lovers of Krishna, they are not ordinary people. They are all eternal associates who come with Krishna down to perform Leela. They are all eternal associates. It's not that poor guru, you know, he wanted son back. Unfortunately, nobody told him about soul. Don't think like that. Actually, guru wanted to show that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead to the whole world. He wanted to show that, just see how powerful Krishna is. He can go to any loka and bring anybody back. He wanted to show that. Yeah. Prabhuji, I'm feeling blessed of having your association for this 3 months. Behavior science sessions. Thank you for the clearing our doubts. Thank you. Also, in Radhesham Das devotional videos, we have put lot of lectures available. In any of you are devotees who have become recently devotees, you go to www.dys.radheshamdas.com. You will get from the beginning, you can hear gradually. There are not only videos, there are also PDF booklets. dys.radheshamdas.com. From there you start, probably 50-60 are ready there. And I'll be keeping building up. So you can hear one by one by one, and you will get a very solid foundation in your spiritual life. I am 28 now. I don't want to marry, but settle well in career, learn lot of skills and bhakti, and become a devotee. Right now, I am out of center to concentrate on career. I feel guilty of eating non-prasadam, staying in hostel. So you're in Hyderabad, okay. So you can study. See, you can stay in Koti. There is a flat in Koti near Abidj, ISKCON Abidj, Hyderabad. And there, about 15-20 boys are preparing for GATE, but they get prasadam. You can stay with them if you want. If you also want to learn skills and build your career and everything. Or there is another place in ISKCON Madhapur, you put in net, you will get. Address you will get, you can connect with them. There also there is a center with prasad you will get. But there you can build your career, do your devotion service, both. Omkar Prabhu is asking, I am trying to preach to one devotee and I am facing a little issue to convince him about meat eating. That student says in his family tradition, eating meat. See, you don't have to convince him about stopping meat eating. Simply tell him to chant. After chanting 4 rounds or something, he will come to you and tell you, hey, I am not feeling very happy when I eat meat. What should I do? Then you tell him, give up meat. That time you will give up. See, you will get the juice of chanting Hare Krishna. Just like if you have a band-aid in the leg, you know, after next day you try to remove it, all the hair also will come. It's very painful. But you put some water, after putting water, remove it, easily, smoothly it will come. It will not pain. Similarly, give him the juice of chanting Hare Krishna, eating prasadam, you know, attending the morning program, reading Prabhupada books, hearing lectures. Give importance to the positive activities. And the negative activities, how they went away, you will not even know. Even many of our students have given up meat eating very easily after attending Sankalp camp. So you give him chanting Hare Krishna and attending these programs. So thank you all very much. I took a little longer today to complete the questions. So thank you for joining the sessions for several days in a row during the lockdown. And you are still welcome. Every day I am doing 2 programs. One between 5:30, 6:45 in English and Chaitanya-charitamrita. Many, many nice things will come there, pastimes will come there. And 7 to 8:30, Putana, not Putana, I mean, tomorrow I am beginning with Putana. It's Demons in Vrindavan Leela, which will be in Hindi. It'll be going exactly till the day before Janmashtami. Janmashtami is 13th or 12th? 12th. So 11th I'll complete all the 21 demons in Vrindavan Leela. I will be over on 11th. I'll be completing. That's how I have planned the timing. So you all are welcome for the same. And then Janmashtami we will celebrate. And then I'll decide further what to do after that. Thank you. Shri Prabhupada ki. Gaur Bhaktavinda ki.